my title. This is about Stop the Killings in Nigeria, which is my country. Stop the killings, stop every the police brutality. Like, it all started with a peaceful SARS movement. First of all, let me explain what SARS is. SARS is like an anti-robbery enforcement. Like, it's an enforcement to stop robberies and theft and all those things in Nigeria. And yes, it was actually a very good thing at the time. But yes, for them to be stopping thieves, robbers and all that. But then all of a sudden it became, okay, arresting people into cyber crimes, people who fake money from people illegally and stuff like that. It became to an extent that even when you're walking on the road, they call you and search your phones, harass you, embarrass you. Even when you are not guilty of such crimes, they either take money from you, they can even arrest you, or at the point they started killing. If you did not give to that demand, they will kill you. Like, it became a very, very, very serious situation that even to, I think it was the beginning of this month, when our president, our so-called president, decided that the SARS enforcement have the right to go to people's phones, like go to people's phones and search everything there and all that, as in go through their phones and anything they see that can implicate them on being into cybercrime, they could arrest them and do anything they want with them. Like, it became too much. They started killing. Like, this killing, so many people have been killed through this SARS enforcement or whatever. So Nigerians decided it was too much. They had to do something about it. They decided to start a protest, a very, very peaceful protest. It was actually... because the protest was very, very peaceful. Just all we did exactly what the government wanted us to do. We wore our face masks. We just walked around and chanted the end SARS and just told them exactly what we wanted. We just wanted them to end the SARS movement. Everything SARS, we wanted them to end it. So the so-called leaders said, okay, they will dissolve the SARS and bring a new one called SWAT. Like, SWAT, isn't it the same thing with SARS? What is the difference? You see, the same people you are going to take away from the SARS are still the same people that's going to go into the SWAT. So what is the need of still bringing such enforcement? Like, we do not want any agency on crime, on robbery. We just want to avoid any embarrassment and harassment and killings. So I think that was what the whole protest, they changed from end SWAT, from end SARS, they changed the protest to end SWAT. We didn't want anyone. We don't want end, we don't want SARS, don't want SWAT. So yesterday, I think the first day, we said on news that schools shouldn't be open to yesterday. I think yesterday was 20th of October. They should be open because of an ongoing protest that's going to happen. And to me, I was really feeling like, haven't they been doing protests since? Haven't students been going to schools? How do they know, as in, this protest is going to be a very, very riotic one? It's going to be very bad and all. So yesterday, it all started from, the one I had at first was that protesters lit up a police station at Orile. Protesters, peaceful protesters that we have been seeing online that have just been giving, telling the government what they haven't even done anything wrong. So from there, we started hearing they are rioting here, they are rioting, they are moving from place to place, destroying public properties and all that. Then last night, I think evening time, okay, yes, the Sanolu gave us a curfew that by 4 o'clock everyone should leave, as in should leave their workplace, that there shouldn't be anyone on the streets by 4, and I think they extended it to 9 p.m. And before, I think around that 5, I'm not really sure of the time, because I saw tweets on Twitter that some people saw some men carrying CCTV cameras like on the toll gates. They were uninstalling CCTV cameras and all the lights and all. Like, everybody was wondering, ah, what is happening? Before I knew, I forgot it, I think around 6 or 7 p.m., soldiers started shooting. They turned off the lights at the toll gates, and soldiers started shooting protesters and everything. They shot up to 70. But I heard 78 protesters died. Like, died. 78. And you're saying we shouldn't have voice in this Nigeria. Like, a very, very, like, I think Lekki is the most peaceful protest. And that's what everyone's been saying. Like, that is like where people are like, ah, I'm not going to this protest, let me go to Lekki, because that one is very peaceful. They are very calm and everything goes smoothly around there. So everyone decided that was the most peaceful protest in Nigeria, and they started to kill people, innocent people. So all I'm just saying is that if you know there's anything you can do, we need to alert the UN. Even the UN, no one is saying anything about this. We've been giving hashtags, we've been saying different things, and no, even the president hasn't even said anything. As in, he hasn't even addressed us. President, he hasn't addressed us on the matter. Like, he hasn't tweeted nothing. So what I'm hearing now is that it's Tinubu, or it is this person that is doing this or that. I don't know. I don't even. All we just want is for them to end this. Even the government, we just need them to change the government. Everything is just wrong. But we're just trying to give a peaceful protest about them ending, so it became another thing. So in case for you, if you think you can help in any way, please do. Just keep on retweeting tweets on Twitter. Anything you see about this movement or this end brutality in Nigeria or end the killings in Nigeria, please retweet. Tag high people that you think can help us. And also, you can sign a petition. My link below. The link in my description box. Yeah. Just sign the petition. I'm not going to say you see it there. Sign the petition. And please, any way you feel you can help, please do. There are a lot of people now in hospital. Even yesterday, no ambulance came to get any of the people they shot, because they didn't allow them to get to the toll gate. Like, I think some of them are still stranded there. Till this morning, some of them were still there. And today is 21st. They were still there from last night. They didn't want them to move.
Look at gunshot wound. Gunshot wound.
What is the name of bullet?
Straight bullet wound. Let's take him to the hospital. This Lekki Egbe. Lekki Egbe.
Listen up, please. It's morning. We're wearing the same clothes. Same matter, different day. But it's from last night. There's no curfew right now. It's morning. And they are not even shooting up. They're shooting straight bullets at us. They are positioned by the side of Lekki Egbe
So many things have happened, and we just need help. Any way you think you can help, just keep on tagging high people you feel can help us, so they can help us in this country, because the president isn't even saying anything. Even the ones that say something, they are not even saying things that can help the situation. So please, any way you think you can help, please do. Help our country. Pray for our country. Even if you can't sign the petition or do anything, please pray. Keep on praying for our country to get a good government, a good governance, good everything. We deserve it. We've been trying our best. No matter the situation they threw at us, we've been trying. I mean, they increase things every day. They increase the price of rice. Like, they didn't make anything better for us, but yet we keep striving, we keep hustling. I mean, during the corona period, they didn't do anything for us. They even made the matters worse. They gave a lockdown, but nothing. The money they gave to our government to give to the citizens, I don't know how much they told us to them to give us, but we got nothing. Even at the local government, they may say, okay, if you want rice, 2 cups of rice for your family. And all of a sudden, we had someone slaundered billions of naira and he started to slump. Slump on the desk when they asked him where all the money went. Honestly, our government is just anyhow. They are not helping us in any way. We are trying our best. We are trying our best. The youths are trying to give a voice and they are killing us for having a voice. Please, anybody you think you can help, please help. Thank you so much for watching my video. I'm really, really glad. Thank you. See you guys next time.